one last boot hook. I would just take care of it and off camera, but I'm gonna do it on camera because it's a little bit different because I have that tool now, which is up here. So, can you see this? This tool? So it's got like this little gap in it. Hopefully this will focus. There we go. And here's the boot hook. The boot hook goes around that snugly. So it's right there. So that when you hit it, it's not gonna clog. Which is nice. It wasn't too expensive. It was on AliExpress. And so I'm gonna aim the hook in like that, the way it's supposed to be aimed. I think you can probably, you know, you have a little bit of wiggle room as far as turning hooks goes. But I want to push all this leather down around the edge. There's something. I don't have a hammer out here. I am going to go. Oh, I do have a hammer. It's not a regular old hammer, but I guess it should be fine. I'm going to be so mad if I somehow manage to mess this up this late in the game. I'm trying to get this hook end to stick out past all this leather as much as possible so that when it starts to bend out, it bends out outside the leather and not in between the leather layers, which would be bad. So I'm just getting like any pointy tool I can find and just working the shaft of the boot hook out of the hole. And it's probably the thickest hole on the whole lineup of holes right here, just because it's two layers and then like also a skived layer in between. I think that's correct. I think I got that all set. And then, what tool was it? Was it this tool that flexes out of the hole? Shit, I should probably do a test. Because I have no idea what I'm doing right now. I'm not sure which tool. This seems like the tool that went with it. Fuck. I don't want to take that thing off of it. Or if I can leave the hook in and take just the hook. Yep, it's out. Fuck it. We're doing a test. Like I said, I cannot mess this up this late, so let's try this tool. Two layers of scrap leather. Ooh. I think it was doing the right thing, but I don't think I did it enough, maybe. I should move it off the marble. Let's see. Maybe this hole is too big that I was using. It's flexing it out. It's definitely going out. Still not 100% sure that's the right tool. To clean your workbenches, boys and girls. This tool, I think this one's too small. Oh, that tool actually worked really nicely. Yeah, I think that might be, this is the tool I want to use. This is probably the tool that I actually came with, but I think we found the tool that we actually want to use. Oh man, it really does lock it on that thing pretty good. It'll get out. It'll be fine. It'll be fine, I hope. Alright. What did I do? There. My hooks. Double check to make sure these are the matching hooks. So I do have ones that are not matching, and that would be a bummer. Yeah, looks to be it. These ones are a little flattened because I didn't have a tool, but otherwise, I think we're good. Pop that in there. Tool. Work all this leather around the outside. Use our little poke tool. This is just a one prod pricking iron, which I pretty much never use. Probably should. But alright, so let's set this bad boy. Try to get this pulled down. That sounds like it's in there pretty good. Oh yeah. It may have actually been a little too much of an angle. It may have angled it a tiny bit. Remember all that big talk I had about being able to spin them a little bit while they're... Yeah, it doesn't want to spin now. I think it'll naturally spin once you start tightening the boot. But that's in there. Yeah, that's sealed. You're good to go. I wish I would have just had that turned a tiny bit more. I think we'll be okay. I wonder if I could turn it with this tool and give me a better grip on it. No. The tool just wants to turn. I could probably do it with some pliers. Or you break it, you know. Those are my options. Anyway, let's get to sanding. I did have the garage door open yesterday when I did this, but I don't want to do that now because I'm talking to you guys and I sound like a crazy person. All my neighbors will think I'm making crazy YouTube videos. Belt sander. Okay. Oh man, this thing on the move. First things first, let's put a new belt on this bad boy. You guys want to see me put a belt on? My garage is completely just covered in leather dust. It's probably terrible health-wise. But, I fuel sand all the time. I get fuel dye all the time too. So, who knows if it's bad? I mean, it's definitely bad. Who knows how bad it is? I guess it's the better thing. So, pop this up. This thing was a bitch to get off last time. Actually, last time I ended up cutting it off with scissors just because I got tired of trying to get it to come off. I think I'm supposed to have like a little vacuum down there. It sucks all the shit out of this as I go, but I don't have a vacuum with that kind of hose. But for sure, I'm gonna invest in one for the next pair. This has just been super ridiculous how much dust is made. But at this point, we're just going for broke. There, we got that on there. Locked it in place. Should fix my headphones. Let's, now we gotta adjust if it has any like pulse. So that's nice and centered. I hope you can hear this. But yeah, that looks. There's a little knob. Sometimes like the belt wants to move that way or move that way. And this was nice and centered. So I brought out one of my trickers to kind of show how close we want to get to the edge of the stitching. I would like to get around like that. They do a really good job. Like there is actually, looking at theirs, It's very flat. It kind of almost comes out a little bit right there. I've been kind of doing the opposite. I've been airing inward. As you can see on this one, it doesn't really come out, but the toe, it's more of like a toe slant. But I'd like to get a little bit more off this. But I'd like to, you see how the heel is kind of angled in? I'm gonna do the same with this one. Man, it's too hot today. I'm getting too much fog in my safety glasses. Fucking safety first, shit. Oh, what the fuck, I have my mask on upside down. Ah, shit. My AirPods are gonna die from how many times I dropped them while making this video. Sorry if that was loud, if I just blew in the AirPod. I'm guessing it wasn't pleasant. But it's fine, no one's watching this shit anyway. Alright. Safety glasses on, safety mouth thing on. Safety boot in hand. Shit, I wonder if I should. I'm gonna try to carve a little bit off of this first on the old Landis. This thing is, you get to the washroom here. This thing is kind of ridiculous for how much sole is left. It's gonna be a hell of a job if I don't cut some of this off. Grinding, more of a grinding than a sanding if I don't get this trimmed. Just go nice and slow. If things start to like turn away you don't like, just stop. You don't have to finish out the cut. You can always just go backwards. Someday I'll get this machine tuned up properly. But in the meantime, it'll be fine. Since it's not cutting all the way through, it's making it so it's very easy to finish the cut. Like, so this off is cutting really well through the sole leather, but the softer upper leather that's coming out is having some issues. Alright. Anyway, got this more shaped for sanding. Oh, my glasses are so fucking foggy. I feel like I've started to cuss more and more as this thing has gone on. So, before like the sander gets so loud that you can't really hear what I'm talking about. The belt is going that way. So, not that it matters that much, but, oh shit, the other thing that you should do before this. Ow, drop your fucking headphones. Fuck. These headphones are awful. They stand great, I love it. I love my AirPods to death, but they fall out when you're putting on a safety on safety goggles and safety mask. So, before you do this, to protect your nice upper, you want to tape it up. That's why I have masking tape. It's not going to protect it from like a real big botch, but it's going to give you like a little bit of just oh shit protection if you get mess things up a little bit and accidentally go to like scuff the upper. It'll hopefully just be that last line of defense. A bit of glue in there. Yeah, whatever. Last line of defense against just a mistake this late in the game. Take all the precautions you can. Unless your shit's going real shitty. And just like, man, keep on getting shittier. Who cares? Like, just learn this shit.
That's kind of how I did my first pair. I was like, things started to go downhill, and I just started to go faster. I was like, shit, I don't care. Everything's wonky. I just want to learn. This pair is actually turning out good in that, like, it's putting making the pressure higher for me. Like, shit, I'm actually going to be wearing these. I got to make sure I treat this shit right. You can see right here, this is one of the things I don't really like. This, see this little bit of, like, kind of foldy bit right here? It's a little bit loose. I think that's because, so I started stitching the stitch down up here. And as I worked it this way, like, a little bit of, like, the slack just kind of got moved over this way through the stitching, stitch by stitch, when it should have, like, if you properly came from both sides, not properly, I don't know if that's proper technique, you did that, it would kind of put the bunch at the end, at the toe, and then you would kind of squish it out. But instead, it kind of gave it a little off balance and made that little bit of flabbiness over there, which also occurred on this shoe on the other side, because this is on the instep of this one, the outstep of the other one, because the same thing, I started on this side, I stitched over, and there's like this little divot of where things got a little bit bunched up. And that one actually had done the right the first time, and it didn't have that divot. Oops, sorry. And then when I had to remove the upper, or I had to remove that stitching to get in and saw out the insole, I missed like one stitch on the way back, and everything bunched up. Oh well, it's one of those things that like looks bad when your shoes are brand new. But it'll just be part of the shoe once you like get a little bit of wear in them. Like they're always gonna get a little bit of wonkiness going on once you wear them a little bit. And that's one of those things. I don't think it's gonna be terrible, but if you're like on Reddit and you're gonna complain and you're gonna send your shoes back to the factory and you're gonna write a mean scathing post about them, and that's what Reddit's for. Just being real upset about stuff. I'm kidding, guys. I know you guys pay $800 for a pair of shoes. They should be perfect. But yeah, I'm realizing how difficult it is to actually have a perfect pair. So anyway, before I get to the sanding, this side is gonna be coming down that way. This is hard. This is a flat surface. I can grind against this. Also, this thing's wobbly. I don't know why I can't seem to get it to not wobble. I really wish it wouldn't. This is good for the curve. And then this backside has a little bit of give. You can't really see, but there's nothing supporting it. So it's good for like getting rid of like rough edges and stuff, because it can kind of wrap around. It has a little bit of give against the sanding. So I'm going to use that side a lot for... See if I can fix this real quick. You guys get to watch me. Cheapest shit. Alright, I'm just gonna do it. If it comes too much of a problem, I'll fix it then. I'll deal with it then. One last thing. For those of you not used to using tools like this, if you think I should be wearing gloves because I'm gonna sand my fingernails off or something, that's what I would think too. I was like, oh man, shit, I should probably be wearing gloves. And then the truth is that you should not be wearing gloves, because gloves can get caught in things that are rotating like this and rip your hands off, rather than like
You bump a knuckle against it, you lose your skin. You bump a knuckle and your glove gets caught, like it'll rip shit to shreds. Alright, so let's try this again.
All right, I'm gonna do a little bit of work on the other pair. Make sure you don't get the laces anywhere near this kit. I should be taking the laces out, but... Okay, if you watched all that shit, I'm all sweaty now. But I think we're gonna have to trim off this till we really know what shape it is. Like, see all this like fringy stuff. But I think we got it pretty good. Maybe this spot might need a tiny bit more, but this is where the shoe, the stitching went in. So the curve is nice. This is where the stitching like went in a little bit, kind of got fucked up. The curve of the shoe is nice. If you look at the actual like curve here, it's good. Ooh, that one's real close to that edge. Yeah, it's fine. But the stitching dents in, so it doesn't look perfect with the stitching, but I think I'll be okay. And I'm gonna go do some edge work on this. We're almost done, shit.